Welcome to Vice City Academy. This is episode 2 of the series, and today we're going to be looking at mouse settings. When you first launch Vice City, a settings file is created. Inside this settings file is your mouse settings. However, by default, these aren't very good. The aim of this video is to show you how you can improve these settings, and hopefully improve your aim overall. So when it comes to mouse settings, there's two areas we look at. There's the X-axis, which controls the camera left and right, and there's the Y-axis, which controls the camera up and down. However, the problem with the settings file that Vice City creates is that there can be a big imbalance between the X and the Y-axis. This can lead to feeling very clunky in-game when using the mouse and trying to aim. Depending on your mouse and how much DPI it has, the default settings file can be a nightmare to use. Check out the following video where I try to aim at some players. You'll see that my crosshair jumps all over the screen and I'm really unable to stabilise it. Let's take a look at the different ways you can fine-tune your mouse settings. The first and most obvious way to change mouse sensitivity options is through the Options menu. You can do this by going to Escape, Options, Controller Setup, Mouse Settings, and here we have the sensitivity value. By default it's set to 8 bars. Since my sensitivity is really high at the moment, I'll try to aim. You can find out how your sensitivity currently is by aiming at something in the distance, for example this tree, and trying to perform a circular motion. As you can see, it jumps a lot at the moment, and I'm really unable to do a smooth circle. So let's go back to the options. We can try and improve this by lowering the sensitivity, so in this case I'm going to lower it by half to 4 bars. This time it's a little bit smoother, but still not quite what we want. It still jumps a little. So again, we'll half it, this time to 2 bars, and we'll try again. Yep, this is much better. It's a lot more smooth, as you can see. Keep tweaking the mouse value until you find something that's comfy and natural to use. Mine is currently set to 2 bars, however, you may find that yours is more comfy at 4 bars or 5 bars, depending on the mouse you have. You want to find a sensitivity option where you can aim at targets at a long range without the cursor jumping, but at the same time have enough sensitivity to be able to move the camera left and right quickly for targets at close range. This is important because over time your hand will begin to develop muscle memory in regards to the mouse. So the more natural that the mouse feels to you at the moment, the quicker and easier it will be to build muscle memory. The last thing you really want to do is build muscle memory on mouse settings that are really uncomfy to use. In the end, you'll probably just make your aim worse and frustrate yourself. As we previously mentioned, there is 2 axes, the X-axis and the Y-axis. The big problem with this here is that changing this value only affects the X-axis and doesn't affect the Y-axis. This can lead to configuration problems such as being able to look left and right very fast, but up and down are too slow. So another way to change the mouse sensitivity value would be to directly do it through VCMP. We can do this by a command, which is if you open the chat box, / setconfig game _ sensitivity, then the value. For example, as a base value I'll try to use 0.000. Then let's say 5, and as you see in the chat box, it tells you that the sensitivity has been changed. So you can play around with this by opening the chat box again, pressing up on the keyboard, and that will bring the last command that you typed in. Then we can delete the 5, for example, and change it to 4. See, this is a little bit less sensitive now. Again, we try it, this time to 3. And even more less sensitive. But say I wanted to be much, much more sensitive, so I could put it to, instead of 0.0003, I could try 0.00 with two zeros this time. As you see, that is extremely sensitive. That's really bad, we don't want that. But you get the idea. The good thing about doing it this way as well is that, as opposed to the options menu here, if the game crashes or you quit, you have to set this value every time you come in game. However, if you do it via command, VCMP will save it, and then every time you join the game or launch the game, then your settings will be kept. So that's the good thing about that. So another command that we have is the mouse ratio command. This lets us set the balance between the x-axis and the y-axis. To use this command, we open the chat box again and we type /setconfig game underline sensitivity underline ratio, and the acceptable values for this are between 0.5 and 2.0. So for this we're going to try 0.5, which should put the y-axis, I believe, to half the value of the x-axis. So look left and right quite fast, and then y-axis up and down should be about half of that, as we can see. Now let's try 2.0, and you should see that the y-axis is moving up and down very fast, and the x-axis, yep, is quite slow. So whatever you prefer is a personal preference to you. So whatever feels comfy for you, just use that. I personally prefer 1.0, as I think it's quite balanced and it's just the most comfy for myself to use. But like I said, try what works for you and use that. Now the third and final solution is to configure your mouse through driver software. Usually driver software is only available for some mice, such as gaming mice, so this might not be suitable for you. Here I've got the Razer software because I've got a Razer mouse, so I'll be using this as an example. So, to begin with, we want to create a new profile. I've currently got a default desktop profile which I use at the moment, so we'll make a new one and call it VCMP. Okay, now that the profile has been created, we got to here, performance, and here we have sensitivity options. Now there's a checkbox here that says enable XY sensitivity. Basically this means that you can set individual values for each of the X and the Y. So let's tick this, and we can set the X up to about 2600 and the Y to about 2300. We want the Y just to be a little bit lower than the X. So now that we've got a base sensitivity set up, we can also add a mouse clutch feature. A mouse clutch feature basically allows you to press a button on the mouse, and while that button is held in, another sensitivity profile will be applied. So at the moment we've got this high sensitivity here, and then we'll have a mouse clutch sensitivity for lower sensitivity. So essentially what is going on here is that this sensitivity here, the base one, is for when the button isn't held, and this is for a high sensitivity for weapons at close range, such as the shotgun, spaz, stubby. And then we'll have another profile on the mouse clutch, which will be a low sensitivity for more precise aiming at long range, such as the M4, M60 sniper. So to do this, we'll go up to customize. Then we select a button which we want the clutch to go on. So for this, I'm going to use number 5, which is on the side of the mouse for the thumb. And then we select the sensitivity option. And sensitivity clutch is already selected because I've set it up before, but just select it from this menu. And then we pick a low sensitivity this time, so something about 600. This time they can be quite balanced in terms of the X and the Y because the sensitivity is so low. So we click save, and now we go in game and see how it is. So here's the base value, which is very sensitive and allowing you to turn very fast when up close. And here's the clutch value, which is very slow and precise. which is what you want for aiming at long range. So because there's no recoil on Vice City, you'll get a much smoother line when going left and right. This will allow you to get those headshots much easier. Here's a bit of gameplay showing the base sensitivity values and the mouse clutch sensitivity values that we set. Notice how much smoother the crosshair is and how I'm able to cover the area that I want to. Here is the base value, which is without holding the clutch in. It allows us to turn quick and sharp, allowing us to fight up close. I realise that this is not a solution for everyone, as it requires a gaming mouse, which can be quite expensive. However, I do suggest that this is highly recommended for the clutch feature alone. Hopefully this tutorial was helpful in some way, shape or form. If you have any questions, please directly PM me and I'll try and get back to you as soon as I can. Or feel free to leave a comment below. Thanks for watching.